We're here today outside Priti Patel's office. You wouldn't believe it, but this is her constituency office. Obviously doesn't expect anyone to visit it very often. She's steering legislation through Parliament at the moment that is going to make demonstrations extremely difficult. It's going to make effective trade unionism very difficult indeed.
Kill the bill! 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 Kill the bill!
Right now, workers across the country are facing employers who are using the pandemic to cut their wages, affect their terms and conditions, to fire and rehire them. And we need to be able to protest and demonstrate against the actions of these rogue employers.
Excuse me, but this is actually private. Please ask you to leave.
I've still got a democratic right to protest in this country until Priti Patel bans the right to protest, in which case we intend to protest outside her office. Priti Patel was my MP. I've turned up outside her office today to tell her that Priti Patel doesn't speak for me, which is trying to ban protests in this country. When we were blacklisted, it was against the law. But the police, instead of arresting the multinational companies who were blacklisting us, actually gave PowerPoint presentations and provided information about trade unionists to the illegal blacklist. They even sent in undercover police to spy on our campaigns that were fighting for better health and safety on building sites, and to spy on our campaigns, including the campaigns for the Shrewsbury pickets, who yesterday were announced in the Court of Appeal to be completely innocent and were framed by the police.
No justice! No peace!
This is a slow slip into authoritarianism, and the only way we're going to defeat that isn't relying on politicians and lawyers, it's by taking to the streets and fighting against it.
I'm happy for you to protest. There's no problem with you protesting. I just don't particularly want you doing it.
That's her
choice.
This is Priti Patel's office. That's the reason why we're protesting outside the office.
It's her constituency office, but it's not. She's got one room that her constituency secretary comes and sits in.
There's going to be hundreds of people next weekend, so right. Just let her know.
Well, I have told the police.
Kill the bill! 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 Kill the bill!
We're here today to demonstrate our right to protest. This is on the back of the peaceful vigil for Sarah Everett, where our sisters were there remembering Sarah, remembering her life and what had happened to her. And the abuse of power and the force that they used was unacceptable and disgusting.
37 years ago, the police attacked our communities, beat up our minors and fitted them up for crimes they didn't commit. It's absolutely laughable that the police need more powers to control demonstrations.
I witnessed firsthand the policing during the 1984 Five Miners strike. Police violently assaulted people on demonstrations and picket lines, leaving some strikers and supporters needing urgent medical attention, scarred for life, both physically and emotionally.
37 years ago, I was a striking Derbyshire miner. On April the 9th, 1984, I was seriously injured and almost killed when a copper smashed my head in. I was later found guilty of threatening behaviour and watching and besetting, despite proving that police committed perjury at my trial. The police have always had the power to kill, to lie, to destroy, to deceive and to rape. They need no more powers. They've already got them.
Our campaign has organised a number of highly successful protests and events. I Make Some Noise for Orgreave Justice event, held outside the Home Office, could have been treated as illegal if the Police Crime Sentencing and Courts Bill became law. Freedom to protest in a democracy is essential to empower us and initiate change.
I think that the government have overplayed their hands with this. We've already seen mass protests erupting across towns and cities across the country. And now the bill's been delayed before it goes to the committee stage. It gives us time to push back.
When there's unjust laws, we have to break those unjust laws. If not, we wouldn't have had the suffragettes, we wouldn't have had the American Civil Rights Movement, we wouldn't have had apartheid defeated.
We'd just like to send a message to Priti Patel. We won't give up and we'll fight this pernicious law as hard as we possibly can.
Kill the bill! 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 Kill the bill!